Please subscribe my channel QA Automated, and if you want to get notified on each video upload, then do click on bell button as shown here. Hey guys, welcome to QA Automated. This is Anuja. In this video, we are going to see how to test adaptive views with Espresso. See what are the types of adaptive view. There are three types of adaptive views, that is list view, grid view and spinner view. So for these three views, we are going to see how we can locate the element, or you can say particular row or particular column inside a grid using Espresso. Why adapters views are used in our mobile application? The main purpose of adapter views is to show large data sets on the screen efficiently. So they have to optimize memory usage and performance by only maintaining a view object for data elements that currently fit inside the viewport. This means that it currently only fetches and shows the data which fits in the open screen size. In this way, they optimize the memory and performance. That's why we use adaptive views. As we know, normally we use OnView View Matcher to locate any particular element displayed on the screen, whether it's a text box, input box, drop down button, text view or image view. We normally use OnView, that is OnView View Matcher. But in this case, in case of adapter views, that is list, grid and spinner views, we are going to use OnData. That's why let us see what is the difference between OnView and OnData. OnView is you can supply matchers that will try to match in usual layouts like linear layout, which is very common and which is invisible on the screen. So OnView you can use only when the element you are looking for is currently visible on the screen. In OnData you can supply a matcher that will try to match a row in the adapter. Row in a list view or a row in a grid view or a spinner view. So if there is a successful match using OnData, even though it is not currently displayed on the screen, it will bring that row to the screen by scrolling itself inside the view hierarchy. So in OnData, you don't have to worry about whether that row is currently displayed on the screen or not. It will find the match, it will take care of the scrolling, and it will bring that particular row element on your current screen. So let us see an example of data adapter view, that is list view example, and we will see how we can locate a row and how we can write our test cases. So this example is available on a GitHub. I'll share the link in the description box below. So I'll open and show you this. Here I'm using Android Studio emulator to show you this example. So this is a list view where it contains lists of multiple items. So 0 to it's 99. So total 100 items are there. Plus each row has two things. One is this text of the row which indicates the item series. And there is a toggle switch kind of button here which is on and off. So these two are parts of this list view. Okay, so let us understand the test cases one by one. So here what first we will do is, first we will see that last item is item 99 because this list has 0 to 99 items. And we are checking that it is currently not displayed on the screen. So we know OnView can only track the rows or any elements which is currently displayed on the screen. That's why we are using OnView, and we are using with text item 99 which is currently not displayed on the screen, and we are checking it does not exist on the current screen. So this test case will pass because yeah, it is not currently displayed and OnView can only locate the elements which is displayed. Now the next is list scroll. So now we want to scroll till the last element, that is item 99, and we want to check that it is displayed. So for this particular thing, we need to use OnData. Okay, So we have written this on row method here on row method, which internally calls on data method and it returns data interaction. Okay, so view instead of means on view is a method inside view matcher class, but on data is a method inside data interaction class. Okay, so how it tracks it on data, it has entry equal to this row text. So has entry with this row text and is string. This text is a string. So if this matches, means when we pass here as a string item 1, then it will check that it has entry with item 1 and item 1 is a string, then it will return the data interaction object, which will be the location of that row. Along with that, it will take care of the scrolling wherever that item is displayed. So say if we are using item 99, it will scroll till the end. So here if you see list scroll on row with item 99 and check, it is completely displayed, and on data it has entry and it check it completely displayed. So there are two ways to do that. We can call this method and do it, or write the code exactly whatever is there in the method here. So for our understanding purpose and for better code writing practices, we have created this method on row. So each time we don't have to write this entire thing, we can just write on row and we can pass our string of item. Okay, so let me run this for you to show this. So either of the one I'll keep, it will scroll till the end. So I'm running it in the emulator. So you observe that we have not written in code for scrolling, we are just calling on data method. But on data itself internally takes care of that. It will bring the element which you are looking for on the screen, unlike on view. On view will only show or track the data which is already shown on the screen. Okay, so it will start running now. So it will launch the app again. Okay, it scrolled till the end. That's why the test case passed. So in this way, you can write more test cases like locating particular element in this. Like suppose you want to locate item say 20, and if you click on it, it shows here the text is changed as a 20. Okay, so you can write this test case as well. So this is the test case. So here it is going to row 30, it is performing a click and it is checking that 30 value is selected. Similarly, you can click on the toggle button like on, and you can check if it is clicked. So by using check matches is checked, you can check that. So try out these examples and practice more on this, and link is there for this particular example. You just have to import it in your Android Studio. So I'm giving you the link. You open that, download that project and open the project using the folder structure here. You will see the structure like this. So there is a name of this project. Particular project is data adapter sample. You have to select on that project and you have to click OK. It will import all the project settings. If you face any errors to import it, it will show in the terminal section, and it will also guide you. It will show you in the Gradle console or error log, and it will give you the link how you can fix your errors as well. So if you don't have proper version of Gradle or something, then you will get that error. So you just need to install that version and you can continue practicing your test cases. So I hope you find this video very helpful. If you have any questions, suggestions, queries, you can write in the comment section below. And also subscribe to my channel so that you can, you know, track this series completely. And if you are interested in learning some other tools of software testing, you'll get the notification whenever I upload any new video. So do subscribe, and if you like this video and if you find this helpful, then please give it a thumbs up. Thank you.